Hello friends, welcome to KSP Academy. Last class we discussed the solution to find these methods. Factorization already over. And after that we have three methods actually: factorization, complete square method, and quadratic formula. In that factorization we have completed. Now we have switched on to that complete square method. Second method is called as complete square method. Completing or complete square method. Complete square method. So in the complete square method, we have to know only two formulas. Those two formulas which are very important. Those who don't know, please learn it. Is I think we know a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Next, a minus b whole square formula also required. A square minus 2ab plus b square. These are the two formulas are required when you're doing the problems. So how to solve the given problem by using complete square method? Let us, I should take an example, then I'm working for yourself. Let us take first problem. 2x square minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. 2x square minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. The concept is simple. The steps are very important. The step number one is x square quotient must be 1. X square quotient. X square quotient must be 1. X square quotient must be 1. If it is other than 1 is that, please divide that. other than 1 please divide with other number. This is step 1. What it is here, x square quotient is how much? It is 2. Therefore divide the total equation by 2. So 2x square minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. This complete equation you should divide by 2. Therefore x square, 2 to cancel, what is the equation? X square minus 5x by 2 plus 3 by 2 is equal to 0. This is a new equation. Now this equation is ready to apply our method. X square quotient must be 1. Now how much is the x square quotient? It is 1. Now next, I should rewrite the question and I start operation. X square minus 5x by 2 plus 3 by 2 is equal to 0. After this, step two is what about two means? Whenever the middle term having a minus, this is follows our a minus b formula. We have to going to apply the formula. We have to split this total equation in terms of a minus b whole square. If middle term is plus, we are going to apply, we are going to open your question in terms of a plus b whole square. Clear it is? Next, here we are having x square nothing but a square. So we can write a is equal to x. We got the answer, a is equal to x. After that, what do you want to do? Minus 2ab is equal, but it is known to a 5x by 2, but numerator is known to. That's what I am trying to write. 2 is equal to, I am dividing 2 by multiplying 2. So till dividing. So I cannot very clearly dividing and multiplying, if 2 is not available, dividing and multiplying. Right, other term asked is, we have a x, we have a 5 by 2. We can write, no question it is. So divide and multiply. Plus 3 by 2, right, asked is. So here, a is equal to x is fixed. But B term, I don't know. Step number 3, what I have to do is x square minus 2 into this 2 into what is A? 2 into A. So 2 already over, A already over. What are the term is there? 5 by 2 into 2 plus 3 by 2 is equal to 0. Next, x square, this I am writing 2 into A into, this is what? 5 by 4. Here this 5 by 4 acts like now B. So a is equal to x is over. Now in this case b is equal to 5 by 4 it is there. B is equal to 5 by 4 it is there. So in the assumption this is a b value plus 3 by 2 whole square. So 3 by 2 is there. So a square minus 2ab plus what is required? B square is required, but 3 by 2 is not a b square. So what you have to do means step number 4, x square minus 2 into a into b. Next step, what is required? B square is required. Here no b square is not available, that's what I am writing. For my component I am writing b square plus b square minus b square plus as your term is there, you can write it down. So this is the thing here. This I am adding and subtracting for my covenant. There is no question it is. Now this complete thing a square minus 2ab plus b square I can write a minus b whole square. What is the left out term? This is the minus 25 by 16 plus 3 by 2. If you simplify that, what is going to happen is x minus 5 by 4 whole square. This is the splitting into 16 minus 4 plus 16. Next, what is the 16? These are 48. What is this here? I think how much you are going to get back here? 25, right? So 5 by 4 is 18. 25, 16, 8 only are multiplied. 16 already is there. 8 is 24. 24 minus 1. It is 1 minus 1. Minus 1 by 16 it is there. So this is the case here. So what you have to write on this? 1 by 4, 1 by 16, send back to that side. What is going to happen in it is this continuous I am writing x minus 5 by whole square. Go back to that 1 by 16. This 1 by 16 I can write 1 by 4 whole square. So next I can write x minus 5 by 4 whole square. About 1 by 4 whole square. This square is going to be cancellation. Those square is going to be cancellation. So but when you are doing the squaring cancellation, we have to do some take care. To understand, I can obtain next cases. So x minus 5 by 4 under root of 1 by 4 whole square. When you are doing here 1 by here root of this one, it will come plus or minus 4. We can write x minus 5 by 4 is equal to plus or minus 1 by 4. You will have two cases. Case 1 is x minus 5 by 4 is equal to plus 1 by 4, x minus 5 by 4 is equal to minus 1 by 4. If you can do it, x is equal to 1 by 4 plus minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, you can write. This is equal to 6 by 4, I can write x is equal to 3 by 2. This is the first answer. If you go here, x is equal to minus 1 by 4 plus 5 by 4, x is equal to 4 by 4, x is equal to 1. This is the two answers you are getting when you are doing a perfect square method for a given question. So it is long, method look like long, but it is very simple. Once again I repeat to understand it very clear, it is 2x square minus 5x plus 3 is equal to 0. First x square quotient must be 1. So your quotient is other than there. If it is 1 is there, this step is not required. If other than 1 is there, before you are having 2, that's what should divide the equation complete by 2. So no question should be look like here. But in x square means you are fixing it is a is a square nothing but a is fixed down than a is equal to x. But next you are maybe it's not a 2ab but 2 is required. But numerator 5x is there. It is not a 2 multiplier. There is no 2, it's not available. That's what dividing and multiplying 2 for your covenant to make it creating a 2ab. Now it is about 2a. So fix now x square 2, a means x left out term other than 2 and a left out term 5 by 2 into 2. This is the left out term. This left out term it will act like 2ab. Now it is a b fix. Now your a is fixed, b is fixed. Next a square fix, 2ab fix. But next b square is required. So you're acting b is a 5 by 4, but if 5 by 4 is b square is not available. Therefore addition and subtraction takes place to make it satisfy your question. Now this 3 becomes a minus b whole square. This extra minus and this becomes a constant term. This I got 1 by 16. That is sent back here. That Then after that, x minus 5 by 4 whole square is there, but we don't want x exponents. So square you can send back to that, it's a square root of 1 by 16 whole square. The moment we are doing, the important thing is step number 5. Root of this one will get a plus or minus, that's what the under root of 16 it's become 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. This one plus 1 by 4 minus plus or minus you can do it. Plus you do it one question will come, minus you do it other will come. So both answers will come. So we have two roots by using a complete square method. I hope it is simple for your understanding. Very clear it is. Please make a 1 by 1. So the understanding some more complex problem I will take to understand very clearly. So other way also I can do it. So let us some complexities are, these are some complex models we are having. Those also I am trying to explain to understanding. So next one I will go little fast. Please speak, focus on the video to understand very clearly. So in this sometimes roots also will come. Just now we have seen that root of 16 is 1 by 4. But sometimes root is not existent. What you have to do is, question number 2 is 5x square minus 6x minus 2 is there. Here x square quotient is 5. But not interesting, divide x square by 5. So x square by 6 by 5 into x and 2 by 5 is equal to 0. Here 6 is there, but 6 you can write 2 multiples, no need to divide this. So x square, this 6 I can write 2 into 3. So 2 into x into, nothing but 2 into x. What is the extra it is there? 3 by 5 it is there. So minus 2 by 5 is there. Because this term should be equated to this only will come. 6x by the radian, 2 into 3, 6, 6x by the. Same thing I am splitting into my denominator. Here a into x is fixed. B means this one. 3 by 5 is fixed. So a square minus 2 into a into b. We don't have a b square. For your convention, b square you won't add. What is b square? Minus 3 by whole square. Plus 3 by whole square adding. Extra term is there, you should write as t is only. This I can write x minus 3 by 5 whole square. What is that here? 9 by 25 minus 2 by 5. It is the requirement of here. Clear it is a. Then you go back to your next continuation. X minus 3 by whole square. What is the left out term will come here? So what is there here? Minus 9 make a 25 here. 5 to the 10. 10 by 25 is equal to 0. So x minus 3 by 5 whole square. This is becomes minus 19 by 25 is equal to 0. X minus 3 by 5 whole square it becomes 9 by 25. So you can open that root. So x minus 3 by 5 is equal to under root of 19 by 25. When you are making a root, you are getting plus or minus 25. That's what I am writing. X minus 3 by 5. I am writing plus or minus root 19 by 25 means you can write 5. Here two cases will be there. One case is positive, other case is negative. Write very clearly this. X minus 5 is equal to plus, we can write here, plus root 19 by 5. Next case minus root 19 by 5. This also equated to x minus 3 by 5 it is there. So this you can send back to that. X equal to root 19 plus 3. I hope very clear it is, or else you can write very clearly. 3 plus root 19 by 5. This is the one answer. If you write it is minus 3 by 4, that's you write plus 3 minus root 19 by 5. So these are the roots for given equation. One is 3 plus root 19 by 2, other 3 minus root 19 by 2. Sometimes root should not open, keep it root, no need to worry about that. If you are making a root, perfect root should not be, maybe come, may not become. We are not sure. Whatever you are getting, you write it out. So this is the way some complex model is there. Concept is you are making one. Then make it to 2 multiples, it is the limit, otherwise 2 divided by d. Definitely here b square you should add for every question, because b square should not be available in most of the cases. After that here plus or minus take care to get 2 roots. This is a way to for a complete square method. If you apply for any method your textbook, you will get answer. Thanks for watching. Please continue for next video for direct method formulas.